Hello and welcome back. My name is Dr. Cheryl Lentz, owner of the Refractive Thinker Press. Today our focus is on tips for graduate study, how to read an academic textbook. When you begin any class, let me invite you to spend a few minutes familiarizing yourself with the specific learning outcomes and course objectives for which the textbooks have been selected for your course. Perhaps simply sit with your syllabus and your textbooks one afternoon and look at the overall course for the big picture. Review the bullet points in your syllabus for the main points week by week, and then review the table of contents for each of your textbooks. Our goal is merely to get an initial feel for your course content that will be covered in the coming weeks. Our next step is to begin your first week's readings. We will begin with the end in mind. Most academic textbooks offer a summary and narrative form, bullet points or definitions of terms for understanding, and discussion questions that highlight the important elements the text authors intend for the student to learn. By reading with the end in mind, you know where you need to end up. Next, review the titles and subheadings within your specific chapter. Again, our goal is to dig deeper to one additional level of detail. By reviewing your chapter titles and subheadings, as well as any graphs, charts, or pictures, you now get a deeper sense of understanding with regard to your big picture takeaways. The final step is now to go back and read the chapter in detail. By reviewing the big picture framework, you now have a much firmer sense of the important content, both from your author's perspective and your course, and what they both intend for you to learn. A few final tips for you to consider. First, limit your study sessions to only 20 or 30 minute intervals. Research shows that shorter study sessions are far more effective, learning in short bursts rather than long marathon sessions. You'll retain far more with more efficient effort. Remember to work smarter, not harder. You may also want to consider reviewing your homework assignments before you're beginning your reading as well. If you have a paper to write, for example, then you'll be able to keep the writing objectives within the forefront of your reading efforts. Congratulations on designing an effective study plan for your academic journey. By creating these individual systems, you are well on your way to more effective use of your time with more effective learning outcomes for your efforts. For more tips on effective academic writing and studying, please visit me at my blog at refractivethinker.com/WordPress. Thank you for joining me. My name is Dr. Cheryl Lentz, and I hope you find the suggestions within this video helpful. Good luck to you in your academic writing pursuits. We look forward to seeing you in published chapters in the future. Cheers!